dying stars can go out with a bang. An enormous explosion called a supernova. These cosmic pyrotechnics shoot chemical elements and energetic particles out into space. And the explosion can release more energy than the sun will over its entire life. But scientists don't fully understand the extreme physics of supernova explosions. That's because there's nothing like them on Earth. Or is there?
Supernovas are fascinating. They are not just distant explosions. They are the source of elements like the iron in our blood and the calcium in our bones. But they're really far away, so there's no hopping on a spacecraft to check one out. In our galaxy, supernovas only happen a few times a century, so spotting one nearby with a telescope is a waiting game.
So scientists are using laboratory explosions to bring the physics of a supernova down to Earth. Here's what we do know. When a really big star gets old, it eventually runs out of fuel. Its core collapses and rebounds. That triggers a wave of high density and pressure that plows outward through the star. When this wave reaches the surface, the star explodes, igniting a light show that could outshine its entire home galaxy. A mix of electrically charged particles, or plasma, blasts into space at about 10,000 kilometers per second. The explosion leaves behind a remnant, an expanding bubble of gas and plasma. Within the remnant itself, a shockwave forms and flings out charged particles to energies that outdo even the biggest particle accelerators on Earth. And that remnant, it can stick around for hundreds of thousands of years.
It's impossible to fully replicate the physics of a supernova in the laboratory. For one thing, a real supernova would blow up everything in sight. But the same physics governs how charged particles flow in giant supernovas and in lab-made blasts that are shrunk down to a manageable size. Scientists also focus on one bit of the physics at a time. They might try to reproduce the supernova remnant's shockwave, for example, but not all the other complicated physics that goes on during the explosion.
If you want to understand supernovas, you might as well start big. The National Ignition Facility at Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory in California has 192 laser beams that can momentarily unload more power than the entire United States uses in a given instant. One team of physicists is using these lasers to study shockwaves in supernova remnants. This kind of shockwave shows up when the blast's plasma collides with other plasma that's already hanging out in interstellar space. There, electric and magnetic fields grow stronger. These electromagnetic fields not only help form the shockwave, but they also ping-pong charge particles back and forth across it. Each time the particles cross, they speed up, eventually reaching extreme energies. But the details of how the magnetic fields form and how the particles are accelerated have been a mystery. Scientists use lasers like those at the National Ignition Facility to produce colliding bursts of plasma, revealing how magnetic fields form within. In a recent experiment, scientists also reproduce a supernova remnant's shockwave, showing for the first time how particles are accelerated. If you don't happen to have 192 laser beams at your disposal, good old-fashioned explosives can also do the trick. Researchers at Georgia Tech are focused on recreating the early moments of a supernova. Let's rewind. Before stars go supernova, they are layered like an onion, with heavier elements like iron in the center and lighter elements like hydrogen on the outside. When the pressure wave inside the star rams through the onion layers, elements from the star's innards are ejected. To understand how those layers behave in the early moments of a supernova, the Georgia Tech team came up with a dynamite strategy. Build a pizza slice-shaped blast chamber to mimic a wedge of a star, fill it with two layers of gas to mimic the onion structure, and add a powerful explosive. To capture the blast's aftermath, the researchers illuminate the gas with laser light, and they let her rip. As the resulting blast wave plows through, the gas layers form bubbles, spikes, and mushroom-shaped tendrils, and some material flies outward.
The experiments show that these kinds of explosions can mimic a supernova, and they might help researchers better understand how elements are ejected from within a star. And better understanding these early stages of a supernova could help researchers explain the complex structures that are seen later in supernova remnants. Supernovas are some of the most extreme environments in the cosmos. By studying them, we are exploring uncharted realms of physics. Bringing supernovas down to Earth with experiments could help us understand other cosmic mysteries, like how magnetic fields form in other realms of the universe.
While the bang might spell the end of a star, it's just the beginning. The elements it releases go out to enrich the cosmos. The shockwave formed in the supernova remnant could collapse clouds of gas, helping to form new stars. And energetic particles accelerated by that shockwave will streak across the sky, perhaps one day crash landing on Earth. A supernova is the culmination of a star's life, but it's the start of countless other stories.